Hello there, it's been a couple of weeks since my last review because I've been busy beavering away in my arcade ready for a party which took place last week. Now I'm back to doing game reviews and this time we're going to take a look at a game for the Famicom Disk System which automatically almost makes it a Japanese exclusive. The game is Famicom Grand Prix F1 Race. Let's take a look at the stats for this game. Famicom Grand Prix F1 Race was released in 1987. Japan only is an exclusive, as I mentioned, published and developed by Nintendo. The price I paid was £6.92, and I only bought this a few months ago, probably only a couple of months ago, so the going rate is still between £5 and £10, so pretty cheaply available game, although you will have to spend quite a bit of money to get a Famicom Disk System, or in my case, a Famicom Twin. So that's the stats for the game. Let's now take a look at the game itself. Let's take a quick look at the disc itself then. Not really much in the way of packaging on this, it's just got this sleeve inside the plastic case with some Japanese instructions of what not to do, I would assume, and some more Japanese text on that side. So let's open it up and have a look at the disc. Unusually for Famicom discs, this one's blue. Most of the time they are yellow, so that's something unusual. Some more instructions about what not to do about the disc. And we just got a little label on there, Famicom Grand Prix F1 Race, and a picture of Mario with a racing car, and the little Famicom Disk System logo there, the little yellow guy in the left hand corner there, Nintendo etched into the bottom of the disc as well, and on the flip side, pretty much the same, but instead of Mario being on there, it's got some racing cars, and also the text for the logo is in Japanese. So that's the disc. Let's now put it in the disk system and get the game loaded. Here's the title screen for the game then, and as you can see, various things in keeping with the Grand Prix racing game. Checkered flags at the top and bottom, and a little racing car zooming from right to left across the screen, and the F1 race logo in a nice sort of shiny metallic font. And a revving engine noise, I might add as well. So as it says there, push start and we go into the options screen. So you've got a few options. You can put your name in, which I have already done because it saved it on the disc from a previous time. Lots of unrecognizable Japanese characters there, and also my name. So it saves that to the disc. And back to the main menu screen we go. Service data is just your settings and things, so I'll skip that. Entry level, I'll skip that as well. That's basically which stage you start at. And so we'll go to the game start. It's a very jolly background music on this option screen. So there's two different types of race. You can play a Grand Prix race, or a time trial race, which is more of just a practice, although that does have some multiplayer elements. We'll have a look at that a little bit later, but let's get on with the main game mode, which is the Grand Prix race. And you go into this screen where you've got a car, and you can basically go and buy other cars from the shop. You start with 380 worth of money. I believe there may be a save game already on this that's given me that amount of money to start with, because from other videos of the game I've seen on YouTube, you don't usually start with that much money, so I'll take advantage of that anyway. To go to the shop, you can buy a variety of cars. Not much of a variety, three different colours basically, and they've got different kind of options in them, like the body strength and the tyre strength, and you can choose to buy or not buy that. Also take a look at the turbo, some are turbo, some are not turbo. There's different kind of horsepower, I think that's the PS on the left, and also there's something that's a number of kilometers per hour, which is a random value of 2.1 on that one, 2.1 on that one, or 2.8 on that one, but that one's non-turbo, so I'm going to buy that one, I think, because why not. That leaves me with 80, which is not enough to buy another car, so I'll get on with the race now. And at this point you have to flip the disc over. and load in the main game screen. And this is the point at which you can choose your level. I'll just start at level 1 because that starts with the easiest courses. So I've got two different cars to choose from. This is the first time you see Mario in the game. You can see Mario's kind of stood next to the two different vehicles. So I can choose the blue car or the red one. The red one's obviously more powerful by the looks of it, although it doesn't have the turbo. It's got better body strength and better tyre strength. The weather, as you can see at the top there, is dry for this circuit. The circuit's fairly straightforward. So I'll pick that car and away we go with the race. So you've got two gears basically, so you start off in the lower gear and then go into the higher gear to get around the majority of the course. And it's an overhead view, Micro Machines style scrolling racetrack. And you get around the track, there's four or five laps. Down on the right hand side at the bottom you might be able to see there's various levels or something. Say for the body strength, the tyre condition and the amount of fuel you've got left. When they deplete too much you need to go into the pits to get those recharged, for want of a better word, but that of course wastes time where other people can overtake you. The big problem with the game is that basically nobody else on the track ever goes into the pits, so it's just you going into the pits, which immediately means that you're going to lose two or three places. Oops, that was a bit of a shame because this guy's in first place at the moment. And I've just sneaked into first place. So your tyre condition gets worn down by going around the corners too fast and also going onto the green sections of the track. As you can see, mine's quite running out because I keep going into the green sections. And as you can probably hear, there's a little bleeping sound in the background now telling you my tyres are almost worn out. So in the next time round, I'm going to have to go into the pits, which is unfortunately going to mean I'm going to sacrifice a few positions in the race. Spinning and sliding all over the place. So I drop back into fourth place now. Hopefully I can claw at least a couple of those places back if I have a good lap here. I'm on the last lap, by the way. The other problem is when you're driving along, if someone crashes in the back of you, you suffer and they don't seem to. The computer control players don't make any mistakes whatsoever. They all progress around the track just at varying speeds, so it's really difficult to get past them. They drive a virtually perfect racing line. So despite some terrible driving at certain points in the game there, I've finished in third place. What you might have noticed is basically every character in the game is Mario. So there's Mario on the left there, who's very happy that he's won the race, and all his pit crew also seem to be Mario as well. They're cheering as well. When we went into the pits you might have noticed that they were all Mario there as well. So not bad going. One pretty poor lap, which is the one where I went in the pits. But I've finished in third place and earned myself 8 coins, 8 money, which doesn't seem a great reward for finishing third in the race. But there you go. So then you move on to the next race and it's more of the same, different track, but basically the same idea. So I use the same car and away we go again. You're placing on the grid, by the way, is determined by where you finished in the previous race, which means I've got the advantage of starting third on the grid or fourth, whatever it was. Not that it's done me a great deal of good at that point. See, that's an example where I didn't crash into the car crashed into me, but I still come off worse. Not entirely fair. It is a pretty tough game. I've played it a lot of times to get to this point where I'm vaguely competitive. One little mistake and you go all over the place and you've got no chance of recovering, unfortunately. bloody slow cars in the way. I'm all over the place here. Alright, so I've just sneaked into first place again now. So the only thing I have to deal with really is the cars that I'm lapping. My tyres are going to be all over the shop by the end of this lap, so I'm going to have to go in the pits again. As you can hear, my tyres are knackered. Ooh. Oh god, this is a disaster now. Can't even get into the pits. I've dropped all the way back to 5th place, 6th place, 7th place. There's all the Marios fixing my tyres and everything again. And from what was a pretty decent performance in the race, I'm now made a right mess of it. I'm determined to crash into pretty much every car I can do now. My best chance is maybe making it up to 6th or 5th place. But even that's unlikely, I think. 6th place might be as good as it gets. Yeah. So, from being borderline 1st place, I've dropped all the way back to 6th due to some terrible driving. And the pit stop again is what really screwed me over. That made that lap last another 10 seconds longer. I did get some more money again there though, which is pretty cool. So again, we move on to the next track, which it's going to have to load in from the disc. You might notice a bit of wobbliness on the screen when it's doing the loading from the disc. I think that's because either not very good shielding on the AV connections compared to where the disc drive motor is, or it might be something to do with my TV as well. So anyway. So we move on to the third race, which again is a slightly more challenging circuit. Same car, no point in going back to the other car. This one seems to be serving me pretty well. And again, it's just a case of trying to get around the track without crashing into stuff, and already I've managed to crash into something. So what I really talked about so far is the graphics are pretty nice. Nothing too spectacular, but nice animation on the cars. The track's quite nicely drawn and everything. Whoa. I wasn't going too badly until the end of that lap there. And the sound, there is music in the background, which you can probably barely hear due to the engine noises. But that music's quite jolly, a typical Nintendo style. The engine noise is quite nice, but kind of irritating as well, you know. It's authentic, and that's why it's irritating. I'm still in 4th place on this race. Challenging for 3rd place, but keep crashing into the 3rd place car, although I've actually sneaked past them now, and they've sneaked past me again now. My tyre and my body are completely screwed here. Oh, that's a disaster. It's gone all over the place now. My tyre's gone, my body's gone, so I'm going to have to go in the pits again. If I even make it that far, because I've now got no body and no tyre stats left, and I've crashed, which is not very good. That was awful. And what that basically means is that I've had to retire halfway through the race, and now I've got the option to just start again, or I can continue, but you can only continue with your remaining cars, so your cars basically act as lives. So I'll give it a go with this one. I'm going to get nowhere with this one because it's a crap car compared to the other one. And I start right at the back of the grid this time as well, just to make matters worse. I don't think my car's any really fast enough to get me any more than sort of 5th or 6th place on this race now. thankful, having said that, I've just sneaked into fourth. The tyres are almost gone again. Into the pits we go again then. The crew of Blue Marios this time. Fixing all my tyres, too slow. I'm now back into seventh place. Not really much more to say about the game, so I'm just going to play through a bit more. I'll try and get to the fourth course. There's four courses in a level. Oh, we've got oil slicks on the track now, so just to make matters worse. And then it just, you can then progress to the higher level, which unlocks different courses. Get away from me. One more lap to go. Very precise control on the cars, I haven't mentioned that. The slightest little nudge left or right and it goes flying off in a direction that you perhaps don't really want it to. There's a lot of oil slicks on the track now. My tyres have almost gone again despite only doing another lap. But I have at least completed it this time. So what does that mean for me? No prize money this time, but at least I completed it. Go on to the final course, which again you can only use the remaining car on. This course is a little bit more challenging again. I got hit there before I even got off the grid. So I'm not going to make it around this track, I don't think. I've got no tyres and no body condition left at all. So one more hit's going to make me crash and that'll be game over, I think. All over the place. So I might make it into the pits here. A temporary reprieve, but I'm now in 15th place, which doesn't bode well. So I'm just negotiating the final lap and my tyres have almost gone again. So I almost need two pit starts this time. Two pit stops, there's no such thing as a pit start. But I've nearly reached the end of the race, I'm not going back in the pit again. And I finished in 15th place, which is not good. Game over, as you can see there, even though I've just completed the last race. Bit of a disaster, especially on lap 2 where I was all over the place crashing into all kinds of things. So that's the end of that. So we're going to go back to the main menu. Oh no, I don't want that. So after some poor navigation of the menu systems, I'm now back at the main menu and I'm going to have a look at the time trial, which involves changing over to side B again. So yeah, a variety of options here. You can have multiple players. So you can play it in a multiplayer mode, although you just take it in turns, so there's not a lot of point in that. You can choose up to 9 laps. We'll just do 2. You can choose a circuit, which I'm going to go with circuit number 5, because we haven't seen that one yet. And you can choose whether to be turbo or non-turbo, or why wouldn't I be turbo? And then you start the game. So it's just you on your own on the track. You can still do pit stops if you need them, or shouldn't need them for two laps. So you just go around the track. As you can see, this one's somewhat more elaborate than the ones I played in the Grand Prix mode. You would actually get to this eventually if you played the higher levels. And I'm just as bad on this one as any others. Here you go through tunnels with a nice change in engine noise as you go through them. fair to say it's a lot easier, not that much easier on that bit, but a lot easier to navigate the track without other cars to get in your way. So it's good for practicing the courses. So that's one lap. Let's go around the second lap and sum up this game. It's kind of fun. It's playable. Pretty good design overall, but the problem is that the opponent cars, the computer controlled cars, are just too good. They don't make any mistakes, and that leads to you making mistakes trying to get past them. You can catch them up, so it's not unfair in that respect, but one mistake and you're basically screwed, which makes it not a lot of fun and takes a lot of perseverance. I'm making a real disaster of this. A lot of perseverance and a lot of playing through the tracks over and over again before, as every single internal tunnel I've crashed into there. Yeah, I did that almost perfectly the first time around. So nearly reaching the end of this track, swerving all over the place. Nice enough graphics and sound, plenty of options, a bit of frustration, and overall not too bad a game. And at that point we shall sum it up. Only thing left for me to say is whether I'll keep it or not, and since it's a Japanese exclusive for the Famicom Disk System, I think I'll probably keep it.
If you only knew the power of the dark side.
2 1 0